Hello everyone, and welcome to JunkBox Gaming. Today, we're going to be doing a solo venture. I'm going to be playing Alan Wake. This is a game that I bought Michael for his birthday a couple years ago, and he enjoyed it, and I really wanted to play it, but I didn't get the chance to buy it, so he let me borrow it, and we're doing a playthrough today. We're probably going to make these videos a little bit longer, since I might only upload Saturday or Sunday, or maybe both days, depending on how I feel. But anyway, let's just get right to this thing. I don't really know anything about this game, except it's supposed to be like a psychological thriller. That's what the case says. So, yeah, let's get going. Alright, all these settings, I don't really care.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
Is this a Stephen King thing? Because he's always a writer in his stuff. That or John Cusack.
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late.
This is like Misery with I Know What You Did Last Summer.
Dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone. I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
All right. Well, I'm not surprised his body was gone. He said it was a dream.
I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Always the lighthouses. What the heck? Whoa.
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder?
You think you're God? You think you can just make up stuff?
Oh, oh.
Play with people's lives and kill them if you think it adds to the drama.
Okay, let's go. Get the heck out of here.
You missed your
deadline. Oh, come on.
Damn.
What? Oh, okay. Jump. No? Okay. Oh, I gotta do it again? Alright, how do I punch? X? No?
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
What the hell is the secret window, too?
How does does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
You are scaring me. Run. Don't look back, that's what I know. Everyone in horror movies always dies because they look back, or they fall, or they do some stupid stuff. Okay, I can't sprint anymore. Come on, you need to get in better shape, Alan Wake.
This way.
Go. Okay, I don't know you, but I'm gonna trust you.
Hurry!
I'm going, I'm just fat and out of shape. I'm getting in the house. Forget you, dude. Oh, crap. I really did forget him. Oh, he's gonna die now.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry, dude.
Stop. No!
Oh, no.
Die. No! No! No!
Oh, my goodness. I did not think that was real. I thought this was just in his head.
Trapped. There was no way out.
Oh my goodness. No. No. What do I do? This door? No. What do I do? Holy crap.
The cabin was a death trap. I had to get out.
Well, I know I have to get out. I don't know how. Come on. Ow. I don't know how. Oh, now you show me the door?
Follow the light.
The door I've been trying to open? Okay.
You are hurt. You should go back to the light. You are only safe there.
Okay.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this.
Okay, God.
For you do not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light. I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark.
Hit your penis, I'm gonna be mad.
You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm.
Oh my goodness, I didn't notice you.
Can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him.
Real now?
He's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun. Pick up.
Now you'll die.
Oh.
You've done well.
Interesting.
Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare.
Is this a dream? Because I just want to wake up.
Over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
You made
okay.
me this way, and now.
Are you the same guy? Oh, bugs. one down. That's probably the same guy. Oh my goodness, I didn't even see you. Alright, we gotta get used to this aiming system. Alright, can I find batteries or... flare gun? Sweet. Okay, sure, game. Whatever.
You're dead. Just like...
what the heck did I do? Oh, that's cool. Alright, I'm gonna save that bad boy. That thing is awesome. Oh my goodness. Jeez, I need to start paying attention. Did you die for good, or...?
I can keep this up forever!
Don't, please. okay, I'm gone. Goodbye. Oh! Okay, okay, barrels, out of my way. Okay, come on, Alan Wake. There we go. There we go. Run. There's something over there. Do I have time? I'm getting it. Alright, I got it. Yes, sweet. Oh, come on, he knows you're there. You're not gonna hide. Oh, he doesn't have thumbs. Sweet. Just think, if that dude had thumbs, we'd be dead. Oh, crap. What now? Who's here?
Alan, wake up.
Shh, baby. Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
So he has trouble sleeping. He's like me, I'm playing this game at like 4:17 in the morning. I haven't been asleep yet. That's actually a cool placement for like a sign to welcome people to your town. Just right on the bridge. That's awesome. It's weird playing a game with health, too.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife, if you don't mind me saying. I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact,
I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Very nice.
I wouldn't mind an interview.
I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right.
Flashlight. I don't have it.
Yeah?
Oh, phone?
Hey, Seller, that was my favorite writer. Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from
Barry. 5 minutes.
He says hi to you too.
Okay, I'm gonna talk to this guy. Oh, I guess not.
Damn yuppies.
Ah, he's just being mean. What was our car? I don't even remember. There it is.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan, Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe it. I've got all of your books.
Stop fangirling. I know I'm the best thing.
And
it's a sliced bread, but
well,
come on.
Okay. Good for you.
I can examine that? Oh, okay.
Right. So much for a quiet vacation.
Try the coffee. Don't blame me.
What's your book? Can I read it?
It'll break your heart.
Is it Hit a Dead or Hit a Hitchhiker?
Is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer.
Do me
another
a
coffee
favor,
thermos.
Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut number 6 in
okay.
The jukebox.
I can't believe
I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation.
I look like 6.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
I'll get another one of these things. Just stealing stuff.
You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker.
Thanks, Rose.
Unbelievable.
We'll be sure to keep that in
it
mind.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah. You need to give it a good solid whack.
Oh. My bad.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
You're crazy. Oh wait, I know that song. Hopefully it's not copyrighted. What are you doing?
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it.
Is this another dream?
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
Okay.
Hello? Mr. Stuckey?
I'm just saying, what's there to be so scared about?
Carl
except that.
Unfortunately, he was taken ill.
but I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
That voice sounds so familiar.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
You scare me.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
You got lucky this time,
young man. I should
listen,
lady.
You can hurt yourself in the dark.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid!
Okay, then.
The Andersons, they're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come back.
Dr. Hartman?
They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Okay, goodbye, Rose.
Bye,
leave this all-night diner.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Just in case of what?
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Oh, crap.
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here. I'm KBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while and see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
I like this music, though. Very short music, but nonetheless.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
Oh, okay. I was gonna go explore.
Okay. Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
I mean, I guess it's a normal fear, but it's kind of weird for a grown person to be afraid of the dark. I don't know.
Come on.
It's a good thing she brought the flashlights. No, not unless there's a waypoint.
Anyone here?
These doors opening like that just freaked me out.
Nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Yeah, you're right, dude. Oh, it is BioShock.
I need to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island. The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
All right, I guess there's nothing up there unless I missed it. What's this?
The Deer Fest.
My radio.
I've already started to arrive.
Oh, I doubt there's anything out here, but...
The water was clear but dark. It looked very deep.
Okay, then. The water looked deep. Okay. I know you're a writer and all, but still, that wasn't very sophisticated.
Great. So much for keeping a low profile.
Oh, another one. Okay, I probably missed something.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
Oh, thank you. You could have done that, you know? It's not dark over here.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
Oh, I see it. What's that say? E plus B?
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Yep, the rule of three, okay. It's three or four, that's all Nintendo games. The old Nintendo games.
Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay, I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
There's more deep water, okay.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
I think that means she dies. Like, I don't know if she does or not, but...
Alice had told me
just
about
that set of words together.
The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
So we're gonna go B&E. That's what E and B meant. It was just breaking and entering backwards. What is that noise? Is that a train? Am I going inside or am I going to the place? Oh no, return to Alice. I didn't even notice.
Alice?
Why do you even talk about the cabin? If, I don't know. What was there to examine?
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
All right.
I'm upstairs. I have a
seat
for you.
Oh, surprise. Well then. Oh, that was the surprise.
Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise.
All right, let's get this God of War minigame going.
Okay.
Oh. You're a big tease. Holy, what the... I didn't even see that owl before.
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone
hey,
keeps...
Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not... Alan? Alan?
Oh my gosh.
I don't, just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. God damn it.
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Good thing she got those flashlights.
Alice?
Alice? Alice!
No! Alice! Oh, crap.
The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alice! Alice! Where are you?
I'm coming.
Alice!
What the heck?
Alice,
oh.
I'm coming!
Oh,
it's
okay.
All right, I'm coming!
No!
What the hell?
Oh. Help me!
I'm trying, girl.
Alan!
Oh, gosh. I didn't want her to die. But I... Yeah. Alright, this is God of War.
Keep going.
He's dead. I saw Kratos did the same thing.
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
Well, how'd he get in the car? Didn't he run a hobo over with this car?
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice.
That does not look like Dr. Hartman.
And I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
You one jealous person.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
A long, dark hike through the forest with probably monsters and stuff. I hope he had insurance, but he probably did. I bet he did. He looks, you know, he probably have insurance. Probably bought it when he was like best-selling author and stuff. I don't know if he was best-selling, Hello? But he was famous.
Hello? Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started.
Departure?
I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Oh. Ah.
Departure by Alan Wake.
He reads it for me, also.
The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
Okay, then. Just hiking in the woods.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Alan, Jesus, don't scream at people. I tell my dog not to bark all the time when he goes outside, and you're not gonna listen to me either.
The lights
but
up ahead
you don't have
a
an
good
excuse.
Sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
This never turns out good. Now, this is convenient. And I'm Ezio Auditore di Firenze. Thought I could jump that window. What the hell?
Anybody there? Please,
Shut
I've been
up.
In an accident.
I don't want to go through that. Alright, I'm going through. Oh,
hey. Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Listen,
deposit.
I need to.
Premium cabins for rent in.
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl.
ducky.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Do I have my gun still?
Oh
no, I don't have anything. What the heck? Where are you? I'm out of here. Oh crap, I guess I'm not out of here. I saw something shiny. Okay, can I pause this? Okay, read this.
Stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Okay. Oh crap. What the hell? What kind of freaking jump was that? Alright, I'm gone. Screw you.
You lose.
I'm not losing anything. Oh. Oh crap.
I had to figure a way out of this.
Here's Johnny.
Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
He already did. Oh, well, he already referenced it. Yeah, okay.
During your...
Alright, definitely taking that. Where was my gun when I needed it?
Trying. It's the lady.
Yes.
Bright Falls Sheriff's Station. Help me out.
Hello? Hello?
Phew!
Of course not. Did I get everything? Holy crap, no way. Okay, thank you. Oh wait, no. Come on, go. Oh wait, probably can't go that way. Oh, well, thank you, fence that opened for no freaking reason.
There were more of them.
Oh. Oh, crud.
My head pounded with a concussion.
Pick it up.
I've never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. I was dreaming. It felt real enough to make me sick.
I don't know why I kicked that, but just I kicked, so I was like, okay.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Maybe there's some manuscript? No? Okay. I like that we have the Gordon Freeman flashlight. Just refills.
Eerie,
well, actually, this is even better.
Was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
I like that symbol. That's a very cool symbol. Oh no! Yeah, there we go. I want to save that flare gun. All right, time to Assassin's Creed this again, or not? No, I just walked over it. I try to want to find all the pages and stuff. Oh, I guess you have to shine the light on them and then shoot them? Like, when they're human you can shoot them, I guess? Like I said, I don't know really anything about this game. I didn't read the manual or anything. That lady, I guess. Where... Oh, shiza, what is
what
that?
What the hell was that?
I don't know, Alan. I don't freaking know.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Yes, be like the, oh, what's that movie? Darn it. With the ninja kangaroos? I love that movie, I don't remember. Warriors of Virtue. Yeah. Nope, not that way. No, this way, probably. Okay, well, this environment is very weird. Oh, okay, here. Oh, jeez. Oh, wait, you disappeared? It's not fair, man.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
I don't like that at all. I feel like I have to look everywhere because I want stuff. Like that. What is that? That might be nothing, but I want it. Can I even get to it? Yeah, I can. I gotta go backwards, but I think, right? I hope this doesn't come back to bite me in the ass. What is that? It's probably nothing, and I just came out for no reason. No, sweet. Manuscript page.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon. But Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that. Not sleeping. Messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
Oh, Barry is the guy that called him on the phone. It's like his agent or something, I guess. Well, Alan, I'm just saying, you better write one hell of a story for this. Alright, this is where I was going, I believe. Yeah. Oh crap. Oh crap, you came out of freaking nowhere. Oh, another one, jeez. I gotta get used to this aiming system. I'm used to aiming down the sights, not with the flashlight. Oh, I can't even go that way. What the heck? No. Oh, this way maybe? No? Can't jump. Oh, I can't jump on the rock. Okay. Proceed at your own risk. Ah, crap. Oh, what's that? Wait, what the heck is that sound?
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
It's broken. I feel like there's a manuscript page that other way. Lithium batteries. Alright. That's what PlayStation controllers have in.
There was no
power. At least PlayStation 3.
There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Is that a ladder? I can climb it? Oops. Oh, I see a green all the way down there. Oh, I see a thermos over there, though. Oh, should not have done that. I don't trust anything in this
game.
With
all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
A ladder? You could just take that ladder gun out. Oh, crap. Is it throwing stuff at me now? Oh crap. Yeah, insert battery, whatever. Did I get them all? Jeez, this game is like a lot more tense than I thought it was gonna be. I don't know, I kinda, so far, I like the action with it because it's, they don't give you a lot. I know, it's like 1-on-3 and you're a normal guy that can't even really run that well. Manuscript page.
I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned.
I did not do that.
Ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
Yeah, I missed my chance when that happened. Ooh, a shotgun. Just gonna stick with the revolver for now, though. Okay. Nothing scary happened. Shoot you. Wait, what am I doing? Oh, okay. That right? Looks good. Alright, I have to check something. See if there's a page over here that I missed, because I feel like if I kept going there would have been a page, but maybe not. Ooh, ladder. Oops. Why is it B to climb? It's weird. Okay, there's a creepy cabin. Some more of this. Whatever the stuff is. Be nice. Chest. Ooh. Lithium batteries. Wow, this game is actually really cool. Just the sounds that just amplify everything. Ah, darn it. I thought he could take that. You know, if anything, I thought he could take that little hop. Man, just the little sounds in this game are crazy. Oh yeah, and it's like almost 5 o'clock in the morning too, and I got all the lights off. And I haven't been, I don't even know how long I've been up, almost a day. Cause I can't sleep either, Alan Wake. It's platforming. America! Thank you. What the heck is that sound? Shotgun ammo, and there's a radio?
Well, I was just outside.
Don't screw me over, radio.
Fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. It makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and it would keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walk.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure. And Toby's a friendly dog?
Oh, Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but just tough for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks, man.
You have a good night now.
Okay. I just want to hear all that conversation. I didn't want to miss anything. Don't want to take anything away from the game. Yeah, flare gun. That's my, like, in case of emergency gun, I guess. Oh, it's that music. That scared me.
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
Yeah, I kind of have been looking for those pages a lot. I'm very interested.
The gas station
so
was
the gas
closer
station
now.
It looks like?
It's
yeah.
Light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best.
Oh crap!
Belly Burster is the best with no.
Monster dog
is second best. The famous dog is.
Where the hell is he? Oh crud! Oh, there you are. What the heck? Oh, I had my flare gun equipped. I did not mean for that. Okay, I'm out of here. Screw manuscript pages. Where the heck are you? Oh, crud, there's another one? Oh, what the hell? Oh, you're throwing stuff at me. Yeah, start. Pick up everything. Oh. Okay. I don't know what that picking up wind and stuff was. I don't know. It, maybe that was just me, but it looked like the wind was picking up or something. I'm not going out there, though. Screw that. Unless I have to go out there. Oh, there's two of you. Oh, crap. Jeez. Well, I found a coffee thermos. I don't know what these are for. No, the wind is picking up or something. Oh, there's another one. God damn. Jeez, where am I going? Where the hell am I going, dude? Read this.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
All right, that's crazy. Okay, I think I'm going in the right direction now. Alright, heal me, light. Alright. This way, okay. I think. Could be wrong. Probably don't have to go up here, but I want to see what's up here anyway. Holy, what the hell? Okay, arrows. Okay, cool. Arrows, you haven't let me down yet. Except changing my gun. Trying not to waste the good ammo. I mean, the revolver's pretty cool, too. Doesn't take that long. Okay. Can you, like, go away? You are freaking me the fuck out. Oh my gosh. There's three of you guys now? Oh no, there's four. No? I thought I saw another one. I guess that was a rock or something. I was trying to save my batteries. Might have to use a shotgun pretty soon. Not another ITV. Oh wait, oh, I didn't even use a TV. Wait.
It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, a quantum suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment. Known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is
no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality! Poor Dr. Colvin. Filled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. In Night Springs.
That was a pretty cool TV show. I mean, you know, it was supposed to be like the Twilight Zone, but that was crazy. Well, there's a page here, okay.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying, or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Crazy game. I don't know, if I see buttons, I'm just pushing them. It's real life, too. Not just crazy dream Alan Wake, like, this infinite ammo or no? Oh, there's more than just him, too. Great. Oh, thought I got there in time. Is this just gonna be an infinite amount of people until I kill them? Oh, I did not know you were gonna attack that fast. Oh, what the heck? Where are you, dude? There's someone. Oh, that might have been him. I think it was because he ran away super fast. Okay. Battery. Alright, I think I got him.
Stucky's body vanished.
Yeah, I did.
Leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Okay, I don't want to do this, but I'm gonna look around a little bit. This game is pretty intense. Yeah, I don't want to fall down there. A thermos, cool. Why are those things still moving? It's creepy. Just walking in the forest late at night. Gas station. Oh my goodness, this is a gigantic deer.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
I think I have to go that way. See if there's anything up here first. I mean, the game's pretty, like, linear, but it's kind of open, too. Like you just want to explore a little bit more. That's creepy.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting, at least for a moment. The sane world reasserted itself.
I should have went back and stocked up on revolver ammo.
Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting...
No, sorry, I cut it off a little short. The audio's like 2 or 3 seconds behind, so... Yeah, that's... I don't know. It's just 2 or 3 seconds behind, so... I can't fix it.
The deer fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Well, that kind of would explain why you don't know how you got your car.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
All right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
I thought I saw something outside, but I guess I did not. Okay. Yeah, that's why I was on there for a while. Thought I saw something outside, but it might have been the lights. Did I text her? Not text, did I? Never mind. Is this Silent Hill? There's like one police officer?
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen,
we'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me, and then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Oh, wow. Alan Wake. Tiptoes to my room every night. I really like the music they put for this game, though. End of episode one. Everything is all. You know what? I think that's good. We'll do an episode a week or, you know, 2 days a week. Then I drift away. Digging this music, though. The magic night, I softly say, a silent prayer. Well, I hope you enjoyed. And have a great day. Take care. And, you know, high five someone if you can.